Hello, my name is Kseniia and I'm a ClickHouse software engineer. I work in ClickHouse for 1.5 years and I'm going to give a brief overview of caching in ClickHouse. So first of all, what is caching? Caching is a temporary storage, which is often quite limited. And it stores temporary data from the main storage, which is usually unlimited, but access to it is not quite fast. That is why we need caches. So actually caches are everywhere. For example, in our hardware, it's CPU cache, page cache, hardware disk cache, DNS cache, CDN, and so on. And actually, some of these caches are in use in ClickHouse, but I'm not going to dig into these caches. I'm going to tell you about our self-implemented caches in ClickHouse. So a question for you, how many caches do you think there are in ClickHouse? Or you can name them, which you know. Alexei.
Yeah, so, hold on, sorry, I'm looking at the question. There you go.
Mark cache, uncompressed cache, a cache for hash table sizes, local file system cache, DNS cache, and what else?
There are more caches, yes. I actually do not know all the number of caches. Maybe not all of them are not covered in my presentation, like for sure not all of them, but I will go through the main ones. So as you know, the main table engine in ClickHouse is the merge tree family table engines. So they use sparse index, which is all in memory. And in order to use this index, we need a special metadata of the data parts. Of the files, it is called marks. So we need to know them each time we read the data, which can be not quite efficient. Therefore, there is an optimization. We have a cache for them. Why cache? Because obviously they all cannot fit in memory. So we need some eviction. We use LRU eviction policy. And what is actually stored in cache? There are two offsets, offset before decompression and offset after decompression. And they are stored in a hash table with the key is a file path to the column file and the mark number. So this cache is enabled by default. Its default size is 5 GB. And this is very beneficial, do not turn it off. Let's continue. One more cache for merge tree family table engines is uncompressed cache. As you know, data in ClickHouse is stored in a compressed format, which of course has a lot of benefits, but if you have a lot of short queries, then much of the time of the query execution is taken by reading from disk and decompressing the data. And so this can actually be optimized. So if you have frequent short queries, you can turn on uncompressed cache, which is turned off by default. So it can really actually reduce latency and increase throughput for those queries quite a lot. And if you turned it on, it is also quite safe for large queries because it will be automatically turned off for large queries. So they will not pollute the cache and the benefits will remain for the small queries. So these were the old caches, which are quite familiar for many people. And this cache is quite new. This is metadata cache. It was added recently. So as you know, as you might know, when server starts up, it reads quite a lot of files. And if you have a lot of tables, it can take a lot of time. So there's a way to optimize it. We have cache for the data parts metadata files, It's index files, marks files, checksums files, and some other files. So all these files are put into ProxDB on disk. And when server starts up, they are all loaded into memory and provide a quick access, key value access to the files metadata. And this actually can very significantly speed up server startup in case of a huge amount of tables. Dozens. Yes, there was the results from the author of this feature. There were dozens of times. So this cache is actually turned off by default. So if you have a lot of tables, you can turn it on. So let's move to something more general, not only for merge tree tables, but for everything, which is stored on disk. It is a cache for remote file system. Actually, as you know, ClickHouse does not only store data on local storage, but it can also store data on the remote storage, for example, S3, HDFS, and Azure. These storages have benefits over the local storage, but they're not quite efficient in terms of access. But ClickHouse must always be efficient, so we have an obvious optimization that's safe remote for system cache. It is actually not as simple. It is quite complex. It has many optimizations and actually reads, caches only the needed data and reuses it as much as possible. I'll give you some benchmarks. These are three consecutive queries with and without cache. So the first queries can be slower because they need to download the data into cache, and later queries are 100% faster. So, and even some first queries can be faster because the previous queries already downloaded some data for them. So it is reused and it's more efficient. But this benchmark was made for servers on different regions. So it is a little biased. If ClickHouse server and the remote storage were on the same region, it would be less different. But the difference is anyway on the same direction. So let's move on. Compiled expressions cache. As you might know, ClickHouse has JIT compilation. So if you have some complex expressions on your queries, JIT compilation can be used. So for example, if you define a set in min count to compile, if your query was used this number of times, it will be compiled. Compilation does take time, and it would not really be as efficient to compile the queries each time. Therefore, we have compiled expressions cache. Due to it, compiled expressions are more efficient. For example, you can see some numbers. In some cases, it is actually a lot of benefit. So DNS cache. It is actually possible that DNS can, in some very rare cases, respond in seconds. It is really very rare, but ClickHouse cannot be inefficient even in rare cases. Therefore, we have our own DNS cache. It is enabled by default, so do not disable it. We also have open files cache. Actually, opening and closing files does not take quite a lot of time. It is really fast and can be done thousands of times per second. Files are opened quite often, and we can run out of open files limits. So we cache open file descriptors to reuse them. It is also enabled by default. So future work. First of all, I hope you know what is schema inference. It is very useful. It is for table functions when you do not need to write the table structure. So you just write the file name and its format and the table structure is deduced. So for remote table engines, for example, it would be quite more efficient to have this schema inference cached. So this is a huge booster feature for the super feature, which is, by the way, already implemented and will be available in the next release. So next is query results cache. I think it's clear what it is. So I'll move on. Then we have external table functions and engines cache. So not only merge tree engines and so on can be stored on the remote or system, but ClickHouse can also read through table functions and table engines from them. And here we can have also cache and how it is validated by the verifying of modification time. So it will remain consistent. So in conclusion, I want to say that use caches, but with care. Then it will be quite optimized. That's all.